What is Simpson's rule? The goal is to find the area under this curve within a definite range numerically, meaning without using all those integration formulas. To do so, we take samples of the function by dividing this range into equal intervals, where each interval is of the length delta x. Then we take 3 points spanning 2 intervals, approximate the function with a parabola passing through these 3 points, and find the area under that parabola instead of the function itself. Then we do the same to the next set of 3 points, and keep doing that till the end of the range of the integral. This might seem to be a bad approximation at first sight, but as we decrease the size of the interval delta x, the error considerably decreases. I'm not going to show the error analysis here, but check the description if you're interested. Now, how do we find the area under this one chunk? We can see there is a sum of the parabolic segment and the trapezoid. From the previous video about Archimedes' quadrature formula, it can be inferred that the area of this parabolic segment is 4/3 of the triangle formed by joining the 3 points. If you haven't watched the video yet, do consider taking a look. To avoid confusion, let me give notations to these areas. We can write the triangle as a sum of two trapezoids, P1, P2, BA and P2, P3, CB minus the trapezoid P1, P3, CA. Simplifying the equation and substituting the formula for the area of trapezoids, which is the average height times the base. For example, the area under the trapezoid P1, P2, BA is Y1 plus Y2 by 2 times del x, and the area under the trapezoid P1, P3, CA, which spans 2 intervals, is Y1 plus Y3 by 2 times 2 del x. And so, we find the area under one chunk. Adding the areas of all the other chunks, we get the area under the function. And there it is, the Simpson's rule.